Hello and good morning, everyone. Let me know if you can hear me okay, if the audio is coming through. Let me know, guys, if you can hear me. Just want to make sure the audio is coming.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning, Eileen, Caro, Elizabeth, Vanessa, Miguel, Ale, hello. Happy Monday. Today we begin week 15. In fact, we have two more weeks starting today to begin working on our sonnet. We're going to dedicate 2 weeks to developing our sonnet because this tends to be the most challenging of the four poems that we're going to be doing this semester in Unit 4. Today, what I'd like to do, I'd like to kind of review a little bit about some of the examples of figurative language that you have included in so far each of the three poems, the limerick, the cinquain, and the tanka. So the first activity, I want to kind of go through and give you guys an opportunity to reflect a little bit and share some of the types of figurative language that you've used so far. Then we'll spend the rest of today's class, today's live session, to talk about, introduce sonnet, look at the form, the structure of it, and we'll get kind of an introduction to the sonnet. Today, in fact, all of our work that we're going to be doing, the activities that we're going to be doing today, will be inside Microsoft Teams. All right, so I'm going to start by sharing my screen to show you first kind of where we're going to be working. And hopefully now you can see my screen. All right, can you guys see my Microsoft Teams?
Yes.
Okay. So here, guys, what I'd like, you'll notice on the left-hand side, what I'd like for us to do is to go into each of these, except for the sonnet, the cinquain, the limerick, and the tanka, go into each one of these channels. And I'd like for you to share your poem that you developed, all right? So here in your limerick, you can copy and paste your limerick into this space. What I would like to do at the end of each line, all right, so when you copy and paste your limerick, you can post it as five lines as you wrote it out. What I'd like is after each line, any line that you are using figurative language, I would like for you to identify the type of figurative language that you're using. And you can use, just put it in parentheses if you want and call it, you know, a simile, a metaphor, hyperbole, whatever type of figurative language that you're using. Now, if you're using literal language, then you would leave it blank. You would leave the line blank there. All right, so I'm going to give you guys a few minutes here to go in, copy and paste the three poems that you've completed so far and bring those into each one of these channels. Okay, so I'll give you guys just a few minutes to go ahead and begin this activity. If you guys have questions or issues about accessing any of this, these spaces, let me know. Okay, guys, let me give you a suggestion. When you're uploading your stanzas, right, your five lines, see if you can try to include the type of figurative language. If you have an example of figurative language on one particular line, right after that same line, I would put in parentheses the type of figurative language, so it's a little bit easier to identify which line has which type of figurative language. So try to include, again, within the same line, the type of figurative language that you're using. Okay, guys, we'll spend a few more minutes completing this activity. Remember, try to include not only the poem, but after each line, if you're using an example of figurative language, to put in parentheses the type, if you can identify the type of figurative language, again, as it occurs after each line. If the line is literal, then you can leave it, right? But if you have an example of, let's say, simile, metaphor, hyperbole, alliteration, then just identify the type of figurative language that you're using, and I would just put it in parentheses after each line. Okay, we'll give you guys a couple more minutes, and then we'll continue on with the next activity.
Teacher.
Yes.
I'm sorry, I can't find the... I don't know where to upload this assignment or where to put my cinquain, my tanka, and my limerick to do this.
Okay, do you see the channels? They're identified as cinquains, limericks, sonnets, and tankas. Do you see those?
No, teacher.
Okay, do you see the general channel? Let me share you my screen here. Okay, do you see my screen?
Yes, teacher.
All right, so along the left-hand side, you should see four different types of channels.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you can just go into each one of those channels. And so for your limerick, you go into the limerick channel. For the tanka, you go into the tanka channel. For the cinquain, you go into the cinquain channel. And you can copy and paste your poems into those spaces. And try to include, for example, let's say here, Elizabeth has an example here where she's identifying the type of figurative language after each line.
Okay.
Okay?
Yes. Teacher, I don't know why, but I cannot see the, for example, I can see the right part of the screen where it says, for example, search or type a command, and I can see all what is under that sentence, right? But where it says general, cinquain, limerick, sonnets, and tankas, I don't know why I can see it, but I'm going to try, teacher, just to let you know if I cannot.
Okay, maybe try signing out and signing back in. Just make sure that, I don't know, are you on a cell phone or on a computer?
On a computer, teacher.
All right, so, I don't know, just make sure that, so you're under Teams, right?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, and then you go into writing workshop. And when I go into this, it automatically pops up here, and I created these channels as open channels so that any of you guys could go into any of the channels. So maybe just try to exit and come back and see if that helps.
Okay, I'm going to do that. Thank you.
Okay. All right, you're welcome. All right, guys, I think we'll stop there. If you're still working on your limericks, if you're still trying to find additional examples of figurative language, all right, think about how you can do that for the final poetry reading. We want to have at least one example of figurative language in each of our poems. In many cases, we want to have more than just one line. It depends on the type of poem. Some of you have a lot, some more than others, and it really just depends on the meaning, but it's not necessary. I don't want to say that the more figurative language automatically means it's a better poem, but we do want to have some good examples of figurative language, and again, each poem should have an example, at least one example, and you should be able to identify the type as well. All right, so if you're still working on this, feel free to upload this later today, but try to include at least one example of figurative language in each of your three poems that we've completed so far. Now, today we're going to continue working and thinking about our sonnet. We're going to introduce the sonnet today, in fact. I want to show you guys here in the virtual classroom. And if you haven't already, double check here the video that we created last week. right? That your poetry reading that you guys put together. And please double check this to make sure there are no mistakes in terms of just any edits, or just make sure everything is good. If there's something that that I missed, feel free to let me know. But do take a look at it. You guys did a good job last Friday in your poetry readings. And do check this out when you have a few minutes. Okay, this is under week 14 in the virtual classroom. Now, week 15, we're going to begin working on a sonnet. Now, the sonnet is, and we're going to get into the details here in a minute, it's a longer poem, all right? We're going to work on a Shakespearean sonnet. So it's going to consist of 14 lines, and we're going to look at that here in a second. But I want to first begin thinking about why we write a sonnet and why we're going to spend probably almost 2 weeks working on this type of poem. And the first thing I want to think about is, who do you want to praise? Because we develop a sonnet to praise someone or something. All right, so we still want to think about maybe a person, maybe it's an object, maybe it's something related to nature, right? Maybe it's a pet, but it's something that we want to give praise to. Okay, so anything that you choose, you need to think in terms of giving praise to this person, because, or this thing, or this object, because this is the reason typically for writing a sonnet. This is why we usually write it, because we want to praise. We want to acknowledge someone or something that is special in our lives. All right, so I want you to be thinking about who you might focus your sonnet on. Who's going to be the target of your sonnet? And what I'd like for us to do is go in and share something about this person, right? Thinking about who this person is, or I keep saying person, but it can be a thing. It can be something related to nature, okay? It can be a pet. It can be your favorite pet that you had, okay, or that you have still. But think about this person or thing in terms of what or who it or she is, he or she. Why is this person or this thing praiseworthy, right? How did you come to know this person or thing, right? Or when, right? When did this occur in your life? Think of the question words and a combination of the question words that best articulate who this person is or why this person is special in your life. This is what I would like for us to begin thinking about. Even before we talk about the sonnet, is think about first who's going to be the object of our sonnet. Who's going to be the person or the thing that we want to focus on? All right, so what I want to do is to give you guys a few minutes here to go into the virtual classroom and respond to this post. You can add a new discussion topic. And if you want, in the subject line of this post, you can identify who this person or thing is. And then just a few sentences, think, you know, explaining who this person is, how you met this person, right? Just kind of a summary of who and how you met this person. Right. Or if it's something related to nature, like when this, this type of feeling comes into play in your lives in the past. Right. Just something about the target of your sonnet. OK, so I'm going to give you guys a few minutes here today to respond to this post. I'd like for us to begin thinking about who's going to be the target of our sonnet before we dive in to the specifics of this type of poem.
Teacher, do we have to be very specific, like saying exactly how and when, providing dates and things like that?
I would prefer, as much as you feel comfortable with sharing, I would like for you to provide as many details as possible. I want to treat this kind of as a brainstorming activity for you to be thinking about the specifics of this person or thing, so that when we start talking about all the different forms and aspects of the sonnet, that you can then try to bring together the specifics of this person, but later in terms of figurative language and all the rules of the sonnet. So yes, I'm asking you to be as specific as possible, as much as you're comfortable with sharing about this, about, again, the person, this thing that you want to focus on. Okay, Omar, I see that you posted something to the forum. Let me know if you have questions about what we're doing today. In the giving praise forum in the virtual classroom, I'd like for you to think about someone or something that you want to focus on, that you want it to be the target of your sonnet. Usually when we write a sonnet, we want to praise a person, right? Or we want to praise a thing, or maybe even something in nature, if we really appreciate some aspect of nature and we want to give praise to that aspect of nature, then we can typically write a sonnet to express our appreciation, to express or to give praise to that thing or that person. So in this forum, I would like for you to share who or what would be the focus of your sonnet. And think of the question words to think about, well, what about this thing or this person? How did you meet? Or why is this person or this thing praiseworthy for you? And in this space, in this forum, I would like for you to write a few sentences describing the object of your sonnet. Now, the poems I'm asking you to upload to Microsoft Teams. Okay, so let me know if you have any questions about what goes where in today's activity.
Okay, I'll check it. Thank you.
Okay, guys, I'm going in and leaving some comments as you're posting. And a couple of things that I'm mentioning, if you're thinking about nature, if you can think about a specific place or even a specific type of nature, like trees or it might help to kind of think about what you want to write about, what is actually inspiring, especially when it comes to nature. If you can think of a particular place, and maybe that place and its natural habitat is what drives you, what motivates you, what really inspires you to write, think about that one place. And you can mention, if you want to mention that place, you can mention that particular place and all the different aspects of nature that are associated with that particular place. Or, again, you could just focus on maybe a particular type of nature. When we're talking about our parents, one of the challenges is going to be trying to balance and think about, how do I want to present both parents in one poem? Okay, so it's, I think, going to add, and you can certainly do it, and I don't want to discourage you from not doing it, but it's going to be a little bit challenging trying to balance. I want you to think very carefully about how you want to balance both parents, if you want to include, and this is just if you want to include like your brothers and sisters, and you want to state and be specific enough to either distinguish between qualities of between the people, or if you just want to lump together certain qualities that would apply to both. Okay, so try to make decisions about how you want to think about groups of people, whether your parents, your brothers, your sisters, and so on, your friends maybe. All right, guys, I'm going through and leaving some comments again, some really good ideas. And I think a lot of good inspiration here is being shared in the forum. One of the things that I'm focusing on is and trying to help you think about are maybe perhaps in some cases thinking about trying to be more specific, trying to think of that one place, that one moment, that maybe a type of something that was that's a little bit more specific in some cases. Like when you're thinking about music, maybe there is a type of music or even a music group, or maybe even a particular event in your life where that type of music or some music really got you through and you really relate to it, something that you that really motivates you and inspires you to either be a better person or to do great things. So think about, try to be a little bit more specific when you're thinking about either groups of people or groups of categories of concepts like nature or music, so that if there's a way to be more specific, I'm not necessarily saying that that's a bad option, but I want you to think about different ways of looking at those concepts so that you're zeroing in and focusing on something that you really want to write about. Okay, so I think what we're going to do is I want to give you until next class, maybe tomorrow we'll start with the sonnet. I want you to really put a lot of thought into who you want to write about or what you want to write about. Since we're going to be focusing almost 2 weeks on developing the sonnet, I want your decision here to be something that really drives you and something that is specific enough that we can really work out some of the details as we get into the sonnet. All right, so I think we'll stop there, guys, for today. Continue working and thinking about the object here of your sonnet. Feel free to repost if you want feedback from me, but I want you to try to at least have one post so that you're really thinking about the object of your sonnet in terms of it being praiseworthy enough for you to develop this rather complex poem. Okay? All right, so we'll stop there, guys. And we'll start up again tomorrow, and we'll start right off with the sonnet, and we'll have some time tomorrow to start thinking about developing our first lines of our sonnet. All right, thanks, guys. Enjoy the rest of your day, and we'll talk to you tomorrow.
Thank you, teacher.
Thank you, teacher. Bye.